Hi, and welcome to this little series of converting your pixel artwork to vector artwork. So in this first part, so that we are all in the same boat, I'm going to cover what does not work. So what does not work is opening your file, your pixel file. And this is a PNG, and then just going to save as or export and select any vector kind of file that you want. So there are several vector file types, and just saving that pixel artwork will not magically make it into vector artwork. The most important part of this is while those are vector file types, they are not only vector file types, so they can all contain raster artwork. But also, it's not just a conversion, so it's not just opening something and saving it as another thing, because it's just a very different kind of artwork. In pixel art, you have these differently colored pixel, and in vector art, you have actual paths, and that is something that cannot just be converted. Because for the computer, if it would just convert this, it would mean, well, we have all these tiny squares, and let's just create tiny squares, like, you know, this, making a colored square and picking the color and then making even more tiny squares, and that will not work. So that will not be the real representation. So what needs to happen is this, which is now consisting of all these little pixels, needs to be recreated in the shapes that are actually there. So when we look at this, those are not just tiny squares being a triangle here, but it's just a triangle. So the triangle needs to be recreated, and this can be drawn. You can draw a triangle using all of Illustrator's tools, or you can use Autotracing. So actually drawing this using Illustrator's tools, when a skilled person does this, will always give you the best results. But you can also tweak the Autotrace in a way that the results might not be the best ones, but maybe acceptable in comparison to the time and the money you have ready to invest in the task. So that is a decision that you have to make. In the next parts, we are going to look at all the little options you can take and make in order to get better results out of Autotrace.